Hello students, welcome to e-learning. So we are going to again solve one more problem on resultant forces, its magnitude and direction. So here there is one question again. The force 1 is acting at 30 degrees having force of 40 Newton. Force 60 Newton F2, force 2 acting at 30 degrees. And these two forces are acting with respect to x-axis. So this is F1 will be having x component and y component. Force 2 also will have two components, horizontal and vertical component. So if you want to form one triangle here, okay, you have to shift one of the vertical component and place it here. It will form a triangle. So we know Pythagoras theorem that adjacent, opposite and hypotenuse side. So adjacent upon hypotenuse will give you cos theta. Sin theta will give you opposite upon hypotenuse. So vertical component will be sin theta and horizontal component will be cos theta. So similarly here I have written the formula as h is equal to f cos theta and vertical component as f sin theta. Okay. So these two formulas holds good for these two forces, because these two forces are with respect to x-axis. Now we will concentrate on the forces which are acting with respect to y-axis. Theta is equal to 45 degrees, F3 is equal to 40 Newton. So theta is equal to 45, force 4, 70 Newton. It is going to act with respect to vertical axis. So horizontal and vertical component F sin theta and F cos theta. So here it is exactly opposite of these two forces, the triangle. So here it was adjacent side was horizontal, but here the adjacent side is vertical here, vertical component, correct? So if you shift this horizontal component and place it here to form one triangle, so opposite of this 45 degrees you have horizontal component, right? So horizontal component is nothing but opposite side upon hypotenuse, so it is nothing but sine theta. So force sin theta, so the and vertical component will be cos theta, right? So adjacent upon hypotenuse, so f cos theta. So these two formulas holds good for these two forces F3 and F4, because the forces which are acting at the directions are with respect to vertical component or y axis. So now horizontal component of first force, force 1, we have this component h is equal to f cos theta. 40 into cos 30, it is going to give you minus 34.64 Newton. Why minus sign? Because this horizontal component of force 1 is acting in left direction, and the vertical component for the force 1 is 40 into sin theta, because we have f sin theta for vertical component. So force is 40 sine 30 degrees, it is going to give you 20 Newton. So 20 Newton is positive again, because this component, vertical component for this force, is acting upwards, right? So this upward forces are taken plus positive. The right direction forces are taken positive. Downward forces and left direction forces or the components are taken negative. So F2 force, horizontal component for this force. Now we are going to calculate this horizontal component. So it is nothing but again F cos theta. So 60 into cos 30. So it will give you 51.96 Newton. It is positive again, because this horizontal component is acting towards right side. Now vertical component for this F2 force, 60 sin theta. 60 is the force and sine 30 degrees is the direction in which it is acting. So 30 Newton, answer is 30 Newton here. Again it is positive, because vertical component is acting upward direction. So force 3 is having horizontal component, again in positive, because this is horizontal component and this is vertical component for force 3. So here it is with respect to y axis. Theta is based on y axis. That is why horizontal component will be f sin theta and vertical component will be f cos theta. So here it is force into sine 45 degrees, it is going to give you 28.28 newton. So force 3 vertical component is acting in downwards, so it is 40 cos theta minus 28.28 is the answer. Y minus, it is acting downwards, right? So F4, force 4 is having horizontal component and vertical component. Horizontal component is acting in negative direction, so it is minus 49.49 newton. And force 4 is having vertical component, again negative, as it is acting at 45 degrees with respect to y axis. So 70 cos theta is the formula here for vertical component. So all these two forces are acting in minus minus, because this is also downwards, this is acting in left direction. So all the forces, you can find out the we have found out all the components for all these four forces acting in this question. So first understand, this is nothing but the first quadrant, this is nothing but second quadrant, third quadrant and fourth quadrant. Why I am mentioning these all quadrants? Because now we are going to understand, out of taking these help of all the components, we are going to find out the resultant force magnitude, right? So in which quadrant the resultant is going to act, we are going to get it. Okay, so this is first, second and third, fourth quadrant. So if you get the resultant force both summation fx, means the forces acting in x direction and forces acting in y direction, are having both positive answers, so resultant force is going to lie in first quadrant. Okay, if it is the resultant is having vertical summation fy as a plus and summation fx as minus answer, then it is going to act in second quadrant. If you get the summation fx and summation fy both negative, so it is going to lie in third quadrant, because vertical and this is also minus, this is also minus. So here now in fourth quadrant, if the resultant force answer, if you find summation fx as positive and summation fy as negative, then it is going to lie in fourth quadrant. Okay, so just remember this. And now we are going to have resultant formula, means the magnitude of resultant. So the formula for resultant is under root summation fx square plus summation fy square, right? So we are going to find out first summation fy, only summation fy, all the forces acting in vertical direction. And then we have summation fx, means all the forces, its algebraic sum of all the forces acting in x directions, okay, whether it is plus or minus. So now put the values of x and y forces. See, fy, f1v was positive 20, then f2v is again plus 30, f3v is minus 28.28, f4v is minus 49.49. You got the algebraic sum as minus 27.77 newton. Again we have fx summation, f1h is minus 36.64, f2h is plus 51.96, f3h is 28.28, and f4h is minus 49.49. altogether algebraic sum is minus 5.89 newton. It means, you can just, I said that if the summation fy and summation fx are having minus and minus sign, so this is going to lie, the resultant is going to lie in third quadrant. Are you getting this now? So it is going to lie in third quadrant, because we got the answers in minus and minus, both fx and fy, right? So now what is the magnitude of resultant? So put these two values in this main formula of resultant under root. So summation fx is minus 5.89, so after squaring it will be again the same minus into minus will be plus, again here also minus into minus plus. So these signs are just for identifying that the resultant force is going to lie in that particular quadrant. Okay, there is no concern with any calculation part. So a resultant force or magnitude will be 28.38 Newton. Now coming to direction. So where this resultant is acting, in which direction it is acting, we are going to find out. So theta is equal to tan inverse of summation of Fy divided by summation of Fx. So this is the formula to find out direction. So we have solved in the previous video also the same thing. Though, so now summation Fy is 27.77. See, here I have not used any sign because minus divided by minus, again it will be plus. So I have not taken it. So tan inverse of my 27.77 divided by 5.89 is summation Fx. Here it is. And the direction of that resultant force is 78 degrees 01 minutes. Okay. So we got the magnitude and the direction of resultant force. It means this resultant force of 28.38, if you provide it in third quadrant, because these two are negative, right? If you provide a single force, okay, to have an same effect of these four forces, you have to apply a force with magnitude of 28.38 Newton and in what direction? 78 degrees 01 minute direction. If you place this force and apply, it will give you the same result as of all four forces F1, F2, F3 and F4. Okay. So thank you, students. So we are going to have a lot of videos on the channel. So for further notification and further upcoming videos, subscribe the channel. Thank you once again.